All right. Present, Saxena, for you on physiological imaging. And you've got 30 minutes.
Good morning, everybody. And basically, to start with, this is one of the imaging modalities. And I have been trained as a radiologist. And I have worked out on a lot of mammographies. We have done all high resolution ultrasounds and all that. And I'll try, in a couple of minutes, I'm trying to show you how this modality, when mixed with the other traditional modalities, can help in a big way. Yes, I'm talking about thermoscan. This thing was approved by FDA as an adjunctive tool for the diagnosis of breast cancer in the way back in 82. When it was approved, the kind of machines which were there, they were not very sophisticated. The kind of resolutions and the kind of it was the application was limited because of the resolution capability. And now that we have got very good advances in this particular technology, we have got digitalized high resolution imaging techniques and all that, and which makes things quite easier as such. Coming back, what is thermal imaging? See, the best part of the thermal imaging is you are not injecting any dye, you are not exposing any radiation, you are not putting across any radiation, no X-rays, no kind of contrast agent and all that. What you are picking up is the energy that your body is emitting. Your human body emits copious amounts of infrared radiation, and this infrared camera picks up this one. It's totally non-intrusive, and there's no kind of any radiation hazards and all that. All that is the sensors in the camera, they pick up your emitted infrared radiation. What is infrared when we talk about? All of us know ultraviolet, all of us know now infrared and all that. In infrared, there are also different things as such. We have got a far end spectrum, we have different things. We may not be able to see the infrared, but we can still sense what is commonly called as heat. And this is what you experience under a hot day, under the sun, or when someone between the campfire and all that burns. This is what. Now, I can tell you the whatever CC cameras also you are taking, we have got the infrared technology. It is in the night vision also, with this infrared, we are able to see with this particular CCTV, with this, again the infrared. So, a simple question, with temperature is the number one form of measurement, any process you can think as such. Whenever you go to a doctor, the first thing what is being checked is the thermometer, then you check. The nurse will check your blood pressure, temperature, and there is a direct relationship between the temperature and the pressure as well. Let's go back to the history of the medicine, and during this was Daniel Gabriel pioneer who developed the mercury thermometer in the 17th century, and it was, if we look at the some of the geniuses and who really thought out of the box. It was one of the things, Hippocrates would cover the body with a thin layer of water and mud and look at the area which would dry first to find out which internal organs have inflamed. That is the beauty of this particular thing. And this is what we want people should think out of box. People should think about these things, then only we get to some of the newer optional modalities. So this technique is as I already said to you, it has not only proven great in research but also in the daily applications as well. And I'll be showing, this is exactly what is the dermal flow, what is the skin, how the skin is whatever we are picking up the signs of inflammation. We are just picking up this particular gadget as well. Thermography provides data about metabolic workings of the body also. I'm giving a big statement here. Metabolism is the one thing which we never thought what exactly is this metabolism. And here we are having a objective evaluation to know what is going on in the metabolism. We, yesterday I was talking about mitochondria, blah, 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 all that. How do you know this mitochondria has gone down or how is it working? This is one of the modalities with which we can work it out. Okay? Metabolism is a big kind of subject, and this is how the thermoscan looks. You have a tripod, something like the camera, what Kenny is doing. This camera, what I have already said, is a bigger one, and you are attached to a laptop and you get the images whenever you take the scans and all that. And it's a relatively non-invasive, painless procedure with no harmful imaging technology, which allows the physician to visualize the physiological dynamics at an early stage. I try to focus more. The applications are the musculoskeletal, vascular systems, and other stuff. Actually, I try to show one by one. These are the applications which can be used in rheumatology. I can always show you one of the cases where rheumatoid arthritis, where are the hot spots. The patient complains of pain, you are not sure what exactly is the pain. Is it your treatment is responding or not? Or is it you just check your ESR, you tell you go and check your ESR or CRP, it still doesn't show you proper. This is the thing which we can. I can give you a simplest example. Somebody comes with a pain in the neck, you advise him to go for a X-ray comes back to as normal. You go for MRI comes normal, and you say, no, everything is in the mind, you just relax, do some physiotherapy, you'll be fine. It's not like that. You can image the pain also. With this modality, if you are trying to see the back, you do a thumbs on the back, I can show you a number of cases. It's all inflamed, whole thing looks red as such. And we do some lower laser LLT, we try to do with some far infrared sauna and all that. We try to give some injections of ozone also. After that, you see a difference as such. Pain management is one of the best particular thing. Apart from there all, diabetes, we have more focus on diabetes, oncology, and pain management here. And my focus starts with the diabetic care. It is not enough to have all the diabetes. Now you need to tell the patient is he has to take care of his food, his or her food, more than the care of face what you take as such. So diabetic food care, it gives an amazing thing, and I'll show you how we pick up things here. Diabetic food care, this basically, when we look at into the food as such, what we need to do for a scan is take the chair and put a screw there, keep both the legs here like that, and you image the thing as such. And I'll show you the images and what they depict you. When you image, all of you know your plantar foot has got angiosomes. These are all vascular patterns actually. We have a set of vascular patterns, and this is not Mehendi. This is the veins which are there, subdermal veins which are there. This is the pluses of veins actually. Based on the flow here, you get that thermal image basically. And these are the areas, this is the position of plantar venous axis. I just wanted to show you there are some things which helps in the interpretation of the case as such. And this is very important. All the diabetics, why they are getting into problems with the peripheral vascular disease is you need to understand. And this is one of the diabetic of 10 or 12 years of duration, he is bound to get into some of the other problems. The problem he gets is only because of the arteriovenous shunts. They start developing these arteriovenous shunts, and whenever you have this, you start developing this kind of shunt, the blood flow here will be compromised, and you start your tip starts getting numbness. This particular portion, this is not well perfused because of this shunt as such, and you get into problems. And we can pick up this particular thing much before you get a gangrene or you get a non-healing ulcer. You don't have to wait till the non-healing ulcer occurs. These are a few of the images as such. and you have got some hot spots, and these are some of the cold spots. This is the we try to see the temperature of this particular point. This is the normal temperature, and this is quite low temperature. So we need to be free. We have to look at what is happening at this level. Clinically, the patient may not show any changes here, but over a period of 6 months or 8 months, they may get some ulceration here. So you pick up early here. That's the point I would like to show you. This was the case of a callus. You see the callus here, and the callus, this particular shows high elevated temperature. So this is going to get into pressure zone. So now or later as such. And while doing, I do most of the cases. I have got some non-healing wounds and all that. They come to me for antibiotic and all. Everybody is doing ozone. I'm very happy. All of you are getting these cases, non-healing ulcers and all that. When you take a, you need to, whatever documentation we are lacking, we should try to use this kind of modalities and try to document what's happening at that level. See, there are four stages here actually. There is an inflammatory phase, pulmonary phase, epithelialization phase, and rheumatic phase. Just by looking at the temperatures, what are they? These are what ROIs, and 1, 2, 3, these are the things. And you can always grade, and you can tell, yes, I will need 2 months for this patient to get better. Or it may, if you got the patient at the epithelialization phase, what you need to just do is just do some ozones for a week, and he'll or she will be better. So this is what, this is the case what we got as such, and we have done the thermal scan here, and this was the, during the course of treatment, this is the follow-up as such. And the other thing, important thing, I was interested in mammography, and I thought this is one of the most neglected. Breast cancer has become one of the big problematic areas in the metros and all of India, and we have beds now. This is basically a US FDA approved procedure, and it's a clinical diagnostic procedure. It doesn't require more than 10 or 15 minutes during in a OPD procedure. You get an image like this. What the image shows is this is one of the problematic areas where there is some kind of what we call is a, there's a lot of cold spots and all that, and this is not properly. This is one of the areas where probably if you can do a VAPS, because this kind of images we compared with the other modalities of MRI as well as mammography, and the people who had normal mammography, they still reported this kind of features as such. And this is a brief difference between what is mammography and what is thermal imaging. As you know, mammography is X-ray based, thermal imaging is a human infrared emission. We have discussed about that. There's no radiation involved in thermal imaging. The accuracy is more than 78 to 97%. It's been published as such. And whereas you have a lot of false positives in mammography, and basically there are a lot of things as such, maintenance and all that. I don't know how about that. I'd like to show you a few of the things as such. How it picks up the early cancer. We need to understand this particular thing. And there's a guy called Judas. He publishes the theory of neoangiogenesis for every solid tumor. What he said was, a prerequisite for every solid cancer has to be some new angiogenesis, new blood formations, new blood vessels they form. Then only they start going into that level. And we used to do ultrasound and try to see a lesion here and ask them to go for FNAC. And we were not aware, we were not on ultrasound or mammography. We say it can be benign or it can be malignant. We are not sure to go for a tissue guidance as such. So what we, this thermoscan can pick up is, we don't have to wait till this lump forms here. Before that itself, you can see the metabolism in certain areas, try to see the temperatures and all that, and then say that, okay, this is the red flag. This is how it happens. This is called angiogenesis, growth of new blood vessels from pre-existing vessels. Angiogenesis, we need to understand, this is called angiogenesis. What we are getting. I think neoangiosis is a big term as such, and this is called this test, which is called no test, known as Dreskin. It is a topography maps the heat generated by this angiogenic hypervascularity reserve deposits. You can always speak up very early actually. You don't have to wait till the lump forms. It can be used as a screening technique as such. In I'm only talking about angiogenesis only, and when we work on this one, I'll show you some other applications as well. And the other applications are usually like there was a ligand in some of the areas we work actually, and they had shown, they have taken their brain scans and all that. While the neurosurgeons, while performing the operation, they are also looking with this thermal scan, trying to see which is active and which is non-active, and they want to take up only the active tumor. That is what is one thing. Wound management, I was discussing with you. This is what we try to work with that. I have my friend who can always supplement. He complements with the skin grafts and all that. But before a skin graft, he wants the wound to be very granulated, fresh, and all that. Then only he would like to take up. For that, we help him out. Pain management, I was telling you about the kind of pain managements are usually musculoskeletal and neurological. This particular thing, if you see here, this particular man had got a knee joint osteoarthritis. He was having a severe pain, probably not also. And when we do a scan here, we fix up, no hotspots are there actually. All the osteoarthritis, whenever you have pain, you have hot spots. And you have all the cold spots here. This was a guy. You do a surgery also, you do a total knee replacement also, this is not going to improve. You need to pick up. In 100, there are one or two cases like that. Before doing a surgery, deep total knee replacement, this is not going to help you. I was talking about this limiter scapula pains and all that. We just pick up like that, and we do after 5-8 days of sessions, we do, and we look into that. See, this is what I was talking. This is the knee joint, and you have got information there. And rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, and this one inflammatory. You don't have to depend on the SPECT and PET scan now. With this, you can always see the hot spots, whatever, wherever they are there. Clinically, yes. Clinically also, you can have some nodules and all that. But by the time nodules appear, it's too late as such. We need to look at all this stuff, polyarthritis. This is what I was talking about. This is the knee joint, which is quite inflamed here. This is the normal knee joint. This is the rheumatoid arthritis. You see the fingers, how he has got the red spots. And once you start with the treatment, whatever stuff you are working out, this slowly is. And this is what I was. This is called CRPS. It's called complex regional pain syndromes. Complex regional pain syndromes, they won't respond to any other treatment. This knee joint replacement will be hazardous in that. And you have a CRPS in the abdomen also. This child used to have some pain and all that. You do a surgery, you do not find appendix. You do whatever is it, but see, you still have the pain. This is a sympathetic kind of pain. And we need some different therapies for this. We need to work out at the neurologic level. This was a back pain patient who gone for MRI. MRI showed L3, L4, there was a problem, and it was only, they said it's a distal burst. But the patient complains of pain throughout. And once we do that, this is quite high actually. When we this redness over the spine, and throughout this. And after the therapy, in a sense, we did a couple of, it took a week or 10 days, but she's still on the follow-up answer. This is what is the person. And I know after a hectic, you had a hectic time, you're coming from all the way from space, and you may be having some pains here and there. And by the time you just do a thermal scan, you pick up these hot spots here. And after the therapy is something like that. We do some pain management with fix as such. I think this is what I wanted to show. You have any questions, I can always...
What is this LLP?
LLT is low level in low intensity laser therapy.
Intravenous?
No. This is just a, maybe just
Okay, our next speaker this morning, for the last time for this